Last time, we learned how to use a bunch of formulas that make calculating derivatives easier than they otherwise would be if we always had to use the definition of the derivative. Today, we're going to talk about one of the most commonly studied applications of derivatives, the dreaded related rates problem. You might be wondering why we're focusing in on such a specific application of derivatives when there are so many to explore. Well, I can't cover all of them in this overview series, but related rates felt like it deserved a special place in the series because it's so common in calculus courses and because it gives so many students so much trouble. Today, we're going to conquer it. Before we jump fully into related rates, we need to understand the concept of implicit differentiation. We already know from previous sections that we have no trouble calculating a derivative if the left-hand side of our function is y, or f of x, and the right-hand side is something in terms of x. But what do we do if we don't have that kind of clean separation, where we can't get all of our y's on the left separate from all of our x's on the right? That's where implicit differentiation comes in. With implicit differentiation problems, where our variables can't be separated, we'll be treating the x variable in the same way we always have. We'll take its derivative according to the derivative rules we learned last time. What's different is how we treat y. Before, our functions have always been y equals and then something in terms of x, and when we took the derivative, we'd change that y into y prime. With implicit differentiation, we'll treat y like x, such that the derivative of y would be 1, in the same way the derivative of x would be 1. In other words, you'll treat y exactly the same way you treat x. The only difference is that every time you take the derivative of y, you'll multiply by dy over dx. But that's it. That's the only difference. We'll see in a second how this becomes super important when we start working with related rates problems. But let's take a look at the application of implicit differentiation on this equation. As I mentioned, we'll take the derivative of x in the same way we always have. So when we run across 2x here, we know by the power rule that the derivative is 2. In the second term, we come to a y. If this were an x, the derivative of 3e to the x would be 3e to the x. Since it's a y, the derivative is taken the same way, and it's 3e to the y. But because it's a y, we have to multiply by dy over dx. Following the same pattern on the right-hand side, we come to e to the x plus y. Remember that the derivative of e to the x is e to the x, so the derivative of e to the x plus y is e to the x plus y. However, we need to use chain rule and multiply by the derivative of x plus y. We know the derivative of x is 1. The derivative of y is also 1, but when we take its derivative, we have to multiply by dy over dx. Now that the hard part is done, all that's left to do is simplify and solve for dy over dx. Generally, your steps with related rates problems will be 1. Identify the information you've been given and exactly what you need to find. 2. Set up your equation and plug in any variables that you can. Remember that you may need more than one equation. 3. Use implicit differentiation to find the derivative of your equation and plug in any remaining pieces of information such that your only remaining variable is the one you needed to find. 4. Solve for that variable. Let's take a look at a common example to start getting a grasp on how this works. Here's the problem. Air is being pumped into a spherical balloon at 10 cubic centimeters per minute. Calculate the rate at which the radius of the balloon is increasing when the diameter is 15 centimeters. The first thing we know is that the balloon is spherical, which means we'll need to work with the equation for the volume of a sphere. We know how fast air is being added to the balloon, or, put another way, we know how fast the volume of the balloon is increasing. This is the rate of change of the volume, which is not v itself, it's the derivative of v, or dv over dt. We also know the diameter at the point in time in question. Because our equation is in terms of radius, not diameter, we'll convert the diameter to a value for radius. We need to find the rate at which the radius is increasing. Rate of change of a variable is that variable's derivative, so we're actually looking for dr over dt. Now that we know what we have and what we need, we'll differentiate both sides of our volume equation. Remember, treat every variable like you've always treated x when dealing with regular derivatives. This time though, every time you take the derivative of a term that involves a variable, you need to multiply by the derivative of that variable. So when you take the derivative of v, just like taking the derivative of x, you get 1, but you have to multiply by dv over dt. Similarly, when you take the derivative of r cubed, you'll get 3r squared, but you also have to multiply by dr over dt. Once we've used implicit differentiation to calculate the derivative, we can plug in the values we wrote down before, leaving ourselves only with the value we needed to solve for, dr over dt. Getting dr dt alone on the left-hand side gives us our final answer for the rate of change of the radius of the balloon when the diameter is 15 centimeters, as air is being pumped in at 10 cubic centimeters per minute. The leaning ladder problem is another very common related rates problem. Despite the fact that we'll be using the Pythagorean theorem as our main equation, instead of the volume of a sphere as in the last example, the steps are the same. We'll start by writing down what we have and what we need. We'll set up our equation, take the derivative with implicit differentiation, then plug in and solve for our missing variable. Here's the problem. A 41-foot ladder is leaning against a vertical wall. The top of the ladder is sliding down the wall while its bottom slides along the ground away from the wall at 4 feet per second. Calculate how fast the top of the ladder is moving when it's 9 feet above the ground. The first thing we should realize is that we know two sides of the triangle formed by the ladder, the wall, and the ground. The ladder is 41 feet long, and the top of it is 9 feet off the ground at the point in time we're interested in. We can use the Pythagorean theorem to find that the length of the third side along the ground is 40. Our equation will be the Pythagorean theorem, and we'll plug in for the length of the ladder since it never changes. Then we'll differentiate both sides of our equation using implicit differentiation. Remember that we'll have to multiply by dA dt when we take the derivative of A, and we'll multiply by dB dt when we take the derivative of B. We know that A, the distance between the wall and the base of the ladder, is 40. We know that dA dt, the rate at which A is changing, is 4 feet per second. Finally, we know that B, the distance between the ground and the top of the ladder, is 9. So we'll plug all those in, leaving only dB dt. Then we'll solve for dB dt, which is the rate at which the ladder is sliding down the wall when the top of it is 9 feet above the ground. Even though we've only covered two examples here, the method behind every related rates problem is the same. If you just follow the steps we covered earlier, these problems won't give you so much trouble. Next time we'll dive into another application of derivatives, optimization, before we turn to the second half of calculus, integrals. I'll see you then. Click on a video for a more in-depth look at the topics covered. Review this video by clicking the links on the right, and subscribe to be notified of future videos.